in Cancun, Mexico, I talked to Dr. Wallace. He's a ringside doctor at so many fights. Yeah, you know, from LA. He told me he did a study a few years ago that damage to fighters, the most serious injuries happen round eight and up, 9, 10, 11, 12. So he thinks they should lower to prevent injuries, make most fights, not championship fights, 8 rounds or 10 rounds. What do you think?
Say it again. Say it. What the
championship
most,
fights?
Most injuries are what?
Championship would stay 12. Oh. But all the other fights, he said most injuries in boxing, the serious injuries to fighters happen. He did a study. Round 8 and above. That's when the fighters get the most damage. Anything until 8 rounds, then no injuries almost.
That's because usually from round 6 and up is when you actually have to start fighting. That's when your condition actually goes.
And a lot of fighters that lost 30 pounds, that's when they start fading too in the later rounds. They start fading.
It's when all the tricks and all this is like, you already seen it. Now it's just,
okay.
It's a fight.
So let me ask you this. UFC, most fights are 3 rounds, which is 15 minutes total, which is 5 rounds in boxing. And championship is 5 rounds, 25 minutes, which is how many? 10 rounds in boxing about? Because 36 rounds is 9 rounds. What do you think of boxing changing everything and just doing 8 round fights?
Nah, I just wouldn't be.
But
boxing's already
different. It's different. They do 5 minutes at a time.
That's
5
true.
Minutes straight, which
boxing's already, you know, it's a sport where, you know, yes, we
gotta save lives.
Look, fucking car racing is also dangerous. Fucking other sports are dangerous. You know, it's just fucking the streets are more dangerous, man.
Being on a rodeo is dangerous.
Exactly. Yeah. You know, come on.
You know what's the most dangerous? Those people that go to Sky Risers and they ride like a bicycle, the thing on the edge. It's called Street Ninjas. What is it?
I don't know what it's called, but I see.
But I think they should lower some of the rounds in some of these fights. There's no point of mismatching.
I don't think so.
Jeez, also the sparring. They go in. A lot of the damage happens in the gym too.
Yeah, también. See, a lot of fighters don't know, or a lot of fighters don't want to say anything. But maybe they're already injured in the sparring and they don't say anything.
They want to get paid. You want a fighter to say, let me give up 500,000?
A lot of the fighters. I guarantee you, every fighter that's ever fought that's big has gone in hurt.
All the time.
And people don't realize that. They go in hurt.
Mentally or physically.
Because think about it. If they don't go, you'll hear a lot of people hear them say, oh, he was scared, or he's this, and he's that. And for a fighter not to go through his fight,
that's true.
Really, really hurt.
Lindolfo.
Okay, sounds good.
Do you think boxing should have less rounds? Like instead of 10 rounds, only 8 rounds boxing?
It just wouldn't.
But when they changed it from 15 to 12, what was your reaction? Were you against that, Robert?
No, you know, I wasn't against it because I wasn't really. I was too young when that shit happened.
Yeah.
I was too young when that shit happened. I was too young when that happened. 12 rounds is fine, but yeah, don't count them to 8 or, you know, then it's not going to be boxing anymore.
The fight's just starting, Renee. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. That's when they actually had to fight. Now you see.
So what do you need to do? You need to regulate people losing. How's it going?
No, you just.
No, losing weight or.
Look, Elie, I'm telling you, look, maybe one thing that they should do is the day of the weigh-in. Look, fighters stop sparring the week before.
Right.
The last week, 1 week. So maybe do their MRIs and do their MRAs. Or how many fucking exams are they for the
medicals? All the medicals.
All those head exams. Maybe do them the week of the fight.
That's smart.
Because they're coming. Okay, they do all their medicals. A promoter tells them, okay, you're fighting in 2 months. Go do your medicals. So they send the guys to San Pedro. Wherever they do their medicals. But then they still have a month and a half of training, of fucking sparring, of getting hit.
Cutting weight.
Maybe those injuries come after those medicals.
That's a good point, Robert.
Maybe they should do all those fucking MRIs and all that shit the day of the fucking, or at least the week of the fight when they're not sparring anymore.
But then you got those that, let's say it's a big fight, and they're gonna do that. And what if they have to do something with their eyes, or they don't give them another chance to fix it?
See, that's the thing. Then
that's the thing. That
a promoter's not gonna like it because they're gonna lose a lot of fucking money.
But
you could also be saving a life. You could be saving a life.
No, I want
you know, promoters, especially the week of the fight,
yeah,
should be hard.
The banner,
they already built the fucking fight. They already sold tickets. They already sold pay-per-view. They already got sponsors. They already got contracts. And then for the main event to get canceled the week of the fight.
Find a replacement. Look at Usyk's last fight. All the banners and everything.
But it's probably the best thing to do. Do all the exams the week of the fight.
I save a life. Yeah, maybe that's a good solution.
Do the exams the week of the fight.
But let me ask you this. In that case, and I don't know if it happens or not because I've only been to medicals once. Can it be that someone sends somebody else to do the medicals for them?
What do you mean?
Like Virgil will go instead of his son. Because how do they verify that it's really him? They don't know.
ID.
Yeah, but ID. What if you look like the ID? You get a fake ID. No, I'm just saying.
What?
I don't know.
I'm laughing at the commentary.
What are they saying, Peter?
Oh, just stupid shit. This guy said he's happy because he kicked out his sister's boyfriend from his house. Good job.
No more humping my sister.
In the house. It can happen in the parking lot. Robert, how are your dogs doing?
Beautiful. I love them.
Were they happy when you came home?
Eh? You got some new dogs or something?
No, I said once.
Oh. Hey, what happened to the German Shepherds? Mikey.
They're okay.
Oh. Mikey got a new dog too.
Oh, those are yours? Oh, I thought those were Mikey's.
Okay. So Mikey's just training, just staying ready. So he doesn't have to get ready.
He's not training today, so might not have anything coming up.
I'm sure everybody always tells me this. You guys ever go fishing?
Once, boring, most worse than golf. You wait for hours and nothing happens.
Yeah.
It's like you get bored and there's no internet service, so you have no escape.
I'm gonna go fishing. I've never taken my son fishing. Never.
Love that shit.
You can sign up. You leave at 5 a.m. from San Pedro. You go on a boat.
No, but that's how, when you go out there, there's like it's different because you're in the middle of a fucking ocean. There's like.
What kind of fishing do you want to do?
Oh, I mean like in a lake, a little river.
Oh, by yourself, not in a group.
No, because you can hear the water running. And it's good. It's just, you know.
But, what should we eat when we go to India?
Capitans. The cucaracha, the shrimp. That's fine.
Yeah, Luis says, Luis' place is called Sama?
Garibaldi.
And chile burritos. Man, that's
fucking nice.
Wow, everybody has the same shirts? You guys coordinate? So Robert, the year almost coming to an end. Well, how was your year, 2019?
So far, we still got some fights coming up. It's been good.
Any championship fights coming up?
Might have some. We might have some. Well, Jose's not fighting till February. Caballo, depending on what happens with the champion right now. I don't know.
Virgil Ortiz, maybe he'll fight for a championship.
No, he'll probably just defend his title this coming, this next fight. Yeah, why not, title defense? Should be, a title defense. They already placed him right there, right above Pacquiao as the champions. So
where?
Virgil.
Oh yeah, for the WBA?
Yeah,
where?
WBA, Pacquiao's the WBA champion.
Right.
And then they got Virgil as the gold, right below.
Wow, that's big. Well, I'm going to their convention. I'll represent you guys in the meetings when they say, who should Virgil Ortiz? I'll say, if you have to fight Pacquiao. How about Virgil Ortiz, Manny
right
Pacquiao?
Right now, I'm telling you, they have Pacquiao's the super champion, so the regular title is vacant, so we could, you know, Virgil
could fight for it.
The
47.
Yeah.
Wow, that's big.
And that's what I'm telling you. They don't have to fight each other, because right now with all the PBC, the Zone, ESPN, all this, it's hard to make them. So at least, okay, then you are the regular champion. You are considered a champion. You're the interim champion. You are considered a champion because it's hard to make those fights.
Robert, you've been in boxing since you were 5 years old. A kid like Virgil Ortiz, how special is he in the sport of boxing?
Like I said it before. I think even before Virgil came here, when I said that Virgil could be like Fernando Vargas, could be a champion, you know, at early in their career. Fernando was champion. He was 14-0 with 14 knockouts when he became a champion.
Against Yuri Boy?
Against Yuri Boy.
And he lost, and he told me a story how inspiring Yuri Boy made him cry.
Yes, not for that fight, obviously, but earlier before Fernando turned pro, Fernando was still an amateur. We went to spar in LA, and Yuri Boy Campos was there getting ready for a fight. And my dad put Fernando in with Yuri Boy Campos. and Yuri would clown Fernando. And everybody knew Fernando was, you know, the Olympian.
The star, yeah.
He wasn't an Olympian yet, but one of those Olympic hopefuls, and, you know, and everybody knew Fernando was, you know, a bad young fighter, amateur. So, but Yuri would clown him.
But you know what? Much respect to Fernando, that mentally, he didn't let
the
that...
The whole fucking way back home from L.A., an hour and a half, he was fucking crying. Can't believe I got my ass kicked. Garcia, we got to come back next week. I want to fuck this fool up. And my dad's like, Fernando, that's a fucking world champion. That's Jordy Boy Campos. What the fuck's your problem? I don't care. I want to fuck him up, and I want to fuck him up. I'm going to fuck him up one day. Never sparred him again. But took the title from him.
But I'm saying that shows that he didn't let the past affect his future. He did mentally strong.
It was the other way around. It made him stronger.
He probably intimidated Yuri Boy when they faced off.
Yeah,
or
probably.
Do you remember Fernando in those days when he was fighting and he became champ?
Yeah.
What was he like? What was it like for Oxnard, for you guys?
Well, look, it was because it was the same year that we both became champions, 98. I became champion in March, and he became champion like in December. So it was the same year that we both became champions.
Your dad must have been very proud.
Yeah.
Did people treat you differently after you won the title?
Not in Oxnard.
No, everybody's the same. The people hit you up, hey, we need money, we need this.
No, I never did.
That's
never,
good?
Never.
Did you walk around with your belt, Robert?
No.
I would. Pita, if you won a championship, would you walk around with your belt?
Like, to a store and shit?
Yeah. Would you?
Hey, so was Oxnard already considered a big boxing city or a boxing mecca a little bit?
Not as it is right now or anything, but because they've never had a champion or anything. Pero see, there was always boxing since, you know, there was always boxing in Oxnard.